Hey there, community. Aubrey here, and I'm going to bring you another installation of our AI step-by-step labs here at DevCentral. Today, what I'm looking to do is a hello world using n8n and Docker. The goal is here is we are actually just going to connect a large language model with a chat interface via an agent. So we're just going to be proxying our chat through an agent. This will give you a real good look at what it means to have an agent and the kinds of things that you can connect to with an agent, but it will be very minimal in terms of functionality. It's just going to get you up and functional using this technology. So before we get going, there are a couple of prerequisites that need to be met for this lab. First of all, you need to have done the Ollama Basics lab from us. That is going to make sure that Ollama is running locally on your machine that you're running this test from. Now, the other prerequisite is that you've got Docker installed with host-based networking already set up and functional. How to do that is outside the scope of this lab. There are 100 million ways to get Docker set up, and I'm hoping that you can figure that out on your own and come here with Docker and Ollama. So, with that in mind, I think we're just going to get going. So I'm going to share my terminal here and just show the community how to get going on this. So first of all, to kind of show you what I have, I've got nothing. At this point, nothing is running. So if I take a look at my chat history, I'm going to go ahead and see if Ollama is functional, right, by curling localhost colon 11434. And guess what? The curl does not happen. It doesn't work because Ollama is not functioning right now. I turned my Ollama daemon off. Now, on top of that, if I run a Docker PS, you can clearly see there are no containers running. In fact, if I do a Docker images, there are no images. Nothing is functional on this thing at all. So what we're going to do, first we're going to go ahead and create, we're going to fire up Ollama with the all bindings. Feel free, by the way, to just bind it to your IP address if you want to. You got to use the real IP address on your machine. Otherwise, the lab's just not going to work. So we're going to bind Ollama. Then we're going to go ahead and create a Docker volume that n8n data can live on. So in case your container gets smashed or whatever, you can still fire up a new container and have all of the workflows that you had locally anyways. We're going to make sure that those are your stuff is kept separate from the standard run-of-the-mill n8n container that we'll be downloading from Docker Hub. After that, we're going to install the latest n8n via Docker, and that's just native Docker commands. We're going to go ahead and do that, set up the host networking on it at the same time, and attach the volume that we created so that we get that persistent effect. Once we're finished with that, we're going to fire up localhost colon 5678 and connect to it with our browser. Then we're going to request a free community activation key, activate it, and make sure that we're good to go there. Once we're actually in the n8n interface, we're going to do a few things. We're going to create a trigger node, which is the chat interface. We're going to create an agent node, and then once we're done with the agent node, which really does nothing without anything attached to it, we're going to go ahead and attach Ollama to the agent node so that with our test chat interface, we can proxy through the agent to Ollama, and you'll be able to see the power that that will give you, I think, just by getting it done. Okay, so let's get started on this. So first thing is first, we are going to go ahead and export Ollama underscore host equals 0000 semicolon Ollama serve ampersand. So if you don't know what that does, that is an easy way to fire off two commands. That's going to export the Ollama host to listen to all interfaces, to listen on all interfaces. And then we're going to fire up Ollama serve in the background. That's what the ampersand will do. So let's do it. And we can see this working. Pow, we have this working. So now if we do our curl, right, Ollama is in fact running. So we do have a running working instance of Ollama. Now we need to do the Docker portion of things. So Docker volume create n8n data is going to be the first command that I run. So if I copy that and paste here, we are going to go ahead and create that volume, which is done. And now we've got a persistent volume that will be able to grow and keep our n8n configuration persistent no matter what. Now we're going to go ahead and install the latest n8n container from Docker Hub, then run it along with the port bindings it needs, mapping port 5678 in Docker to 5678 on the local host. So here we go. We're going to go ahead. It's unable to find the image locally, so it's going to grab things from Docker Hub. And this does usually take a minute or two to actually extract and pull everything. So let's give it a moment. And that is complete. So now we are firing up that new container. And it is now running on localhost port 5678. So next, we're going to go ahead and switch to my browser. Okay, now that we are here, you can see that there was nothing running. This was the window when I last left it. So port 5678 was destroyed, and there was nothing running on that. If I go ahead and reload this now, it should bring me directly to the Setup an Owner Account screen. So I'm going to put in my email address and my first name, my last name, and a password. We're going to make it super secret so no one can hack into it. Then hit next. And it asks you to customize n8n to you. I'm just going to get started. It doesn't really matter. The first screen that pops up is the send me a free license key. So I'm going to click send me a free license key. And you can see that my license key is, in fact, on the way. I'm going to check my email in a second here. And then I'm going to go ahead and activate this. So checking the email in another window here. Okay, so the email came in. And I can just copy my license key here, and I'll bring that back over into my window where you can head over to usage and plan to activate your license. There's also in the email a clickable button which will take you back to this and auto activate, but I'm just going to show you how this thing works without doing the auto activation, just so we see the complete process. Enter activation key, click activate, and license activated. Your registered community edition has been successfully activated. Now we can go ahead and actually get out of the settings. So we're going to get out of the settings. And now we're going to click the plus sign at the top left to go ahead and start a brand new workflow. Okay. So in our workflow screen, the first thing that we need to do is set up a trigger node. That's always how these workflows start. I mean, I suppose you could start with something else and then add triggers as needed, but every workflow needs to start with a trigger for the most part. So I'm going to go ahead and do this on a chat message, right? So I can, I don't even need to test it. I can go back to Canvas and I have this when a chat message received. Now that chat is down here in the lower left. And if I type a message, I'm going to get an error. So hello to you. And bam. Yep, I got a nice output of a session ID and send message with a chat input. Really nothing is kind of going on with this. So we are next going to add an AI agent node. So right here, I went into the plus sign here to the right of the chat message received. And when I got the what happens next menu, I select AI. The top choice is an AI agent. So I have an AI agent here that is, I'll configure the rest of it after I go back to the Canvas, just so you can see that typically an AI agent is just going to sit there. It needs things connected to it before it does anything. Now the memory is optional. The tool is optional, but we do need to add a chat model to it. So let's go ahead and click the plus sign next to that. And we're going to use an Ollama chat model. Now, the first thing we need to do to bind a model to an agent is to utilize credentials. Ollama running locally is very easy to have credentials for because locally they don't really require anything. All I need to have here is my IP address. Localhost does not work because the container also has its own local host, and it ends up kind of not being a good thing. So I am at 192.168.1.223. And if I go ahead and save that now, my connection tested successfully. So if I get out of this screen and take myself back to the canvas, you can see now that I have, when chat message received, I'm going to send to an AI agent that will then tie in to the Ollama chat model. So now when I type in a chat message here, my output should be a little bit different. So, hello, Ollama. Actually, let's do hello world, right? That's what we're doing. So hello world. And you can see that it's going through the boxes here. It's through the agent. Ollama is processing this and is executing and has sent me an output. Hello, it's nice to meet you. Is there something I can help you with, or would you like to chat? So you're done with the hello world at this point. The intriguing thing that I want you to do on your own is going to be to take a look at the different memory options. These are various databases that will help your agent remember your chats. Okay, so you can actually add that to a database, and there are a whole bunch of different databases that will help you do that. There's also native memory that will let you just sort of do it locally, but that's not quite as good. It doesn't really teach you much. And then the tools that are available are things like, you know, connecting to GitHub or connecting to YouTube or connecting to whatever other services are out there, ServiceNow, things like that. So that will help your AI agent do things like, hey, if you use a trigger word, something like tickets, and you're connected to a ticketing system as a tool, it'll tell you if there are open tickets in your queue, something like that. And the Ollama will take care of actually chatting with you about that. So, that's the basics. You're all done with your hello world utilizing n8n with Docker. Again, I'm Aubrey with DevCentral. Thanks so much for tuning in to AI Step by Step.